Wednesday, January 6th, 1 p.m. Eastern Time, Congressman Dean Phillips took his seat inside the U.S. Capitol.
When I went to the House floor to bear witness to the proceedings, my colleague Tom Malinowski and I took the occasion to leave the chamber about a little before 1 o'clock and looked out the windows because we were seeing reports on Twitter of issues outside. And we looked through the windows and we saw thousands of people gathering behind very poorly defended barricades with only a handful of Capitol police trying to defend the perimeter of the Capitol. And it became apparent quickly that problems were going to ensue. By the time we got back into the chamber, just minutes later, the speaker was whisked away along with the majority leader by the Secret Service. The doors were slammed shut. The proceedings very abruptly ended. The instant that the Capitol Police slammed the doors, exited the speaker and majority leader, told us to take cover and put on our gas masks. I think I speak for every Democrat and Republican in the chamber at that moment. The first thing you think is this can't be happening in the United States, not to mention in our capital. But it was. And at that very moment, the chaplain began issuing a prayer for all of us in the chamber. We were told to take cover, put on our gas masks, and that's when we started hearing the pounding and the commotion and the noise outside. And moments later, we, donning our gas masks, we were told to run from the chamber through one of the remaining unlocked doors.
Running to the tunnels that would lead them outside to the House office buildings, this is what Representative Phillips said he was thinking.
I was thinking, first and foremost, shock that this was actually happening. This is stuff, Jana, that you see, we've all seen happen in other countries. All those countries that we see on television and say to ourselves and our families, thank goodness, you know, we live in America. That was my first reaction as I was running. Staggering. I still, frankly, Jana, can't believe what we endured yesterday. And when I say we, not just those of us in the Capitol, I'm talking about everybody in our country, because I suspect that watching the events of yesterday on a television screen could have been even more frightening because of the distance between those viewing it and what was occurring. Well, Jana, it was horrifying. It's a moment of fear I won't forget.
Representative Phillips also shared that when the lawmakers left, some running, many of them wound up in a room together, not able to leave for 6 hours, lawmakers of both parties. And he said conversations happened there that he hopes will begin to move this nation forward.